Hello and welcome to this video tutorial brought to you by tastytudes.com. In the previous episode, we looked at how to take a vector drawing consisting of various individual vector shapes and strokes and compound it into a single flat vector. We then used that vector as a stencil to cut out all the essential parts that we are going to add color to. In this video, we are going to carry on from where we left off in the previous video and add color to our vector drawing. Now for this project, we are creating artwork for both a printed poster and a t-shirt. In this video, we are going to deal with CMYK colors and Pantone colors and look at the approach for both the poster design and the t-shirt design. What you will soon discover is that there are various technicalities we need to keep in mind to provide the right artwork for the printers. So here is where we left off in the previous video, with our skull compound file open. Here we have our skull artwork that appears to be filled with yellow. If we activate the selection tool, we can actually click on all the individual yellow parts that make up this artwork. Also, now I have some color samples here on the left and on the right. On the left here, I have some color I have prepared and sourced earlier. We have some gradient effects and some solid color samples. Over on the right is some Pantone color references I have found, which I would like to include in my t-shirt design. So if you're following along from the previous video, great. Make sure you have your document open. And if you want to use the colors that I have here, you can open the color source file from the coloring folder. However, if you're new to this course, you will need to open up this document. This can be found in the coloring folder in the project folder. You can download this project folder for free. The link is in the description. So with the project folder open, click Test Project, Coloring, Coloring, Versions, and click the version of Illustrator you're using. In my case, it's CC, and open the skull compound file, and you should have something that looks like this. Now, there are many ways in which I can color my skull design. Here are some examples I have prepared earlier when experimenting and toying with ideas on which color combination I would like to use in my final design. If you would like to take a closer look at this example, this can also be found in the coloring folder in the project folder. So for my poster design, I'm going to use this color combination. And for my t-shirt design, I'm going to use this color combination, which, as you can see, has a more simple color scheme. So back to my document, we are going to make a start. So now it's really a case of selecting each individual yellow part of the skull artwork and changing it to a new color. So with a selection tool, I'm going to click the biggest part in the middle of the skull. And once I have this part of the skull selected, I could simply come over to the swatches panel and pick a color, or I could come to the bottom of the tools menu and double click on the fill color and select a color from the color spectrum. But on this instance, I'm going to use one of the colors I have here on the left. By pressing I on the keyboard, I'm going to activate the eyedropper tool. This tool is going to allow me to pick one of these colors from the side very easily. All I have to do is click on one and see the vector shape change color. I have some gradient effects or some solid color effects. For this part of my vector artwork, I want to go with the white to gray gradient effect. So upon click, we have activated the gradient. But at the moment, we can see the gradient is flowing from the left to the right. So now with the vector shape still selected, I'm going to come over to the gradient tool in the menu or simply press G on the keyboard. Upon click, we can now see a line appear on the vector shape. This is an indication of the gradient flow. With the gradient tool active, I'm going to click and drag a new direction for the gradient. And I'm looking to get the gray to start from the bottom and spread up to the white. If I then click on the line, I can control the distribution of the gradient like so. So that's working just fine. Next, I'm going to press V to activate the selection tool and then click the bottom part of the jaw. Then I'm going to press I again to activate the eyedropper tool and again select the gray gradient. Then press G to activate the gradient tool and click and drag to get the gray flowing from the top down. I can then press V to activate the selection tool and click off to deselect. And that's looking pretty cool. So if I zoom in here, next I want to color the petals on the flower design. Now remember, these are individual vector shapes. So with the selection tool, I'm going to select the first petal, then press and hold shift to select other petal shapes like so. With them all selected, I'm then going to press I and click on the pink color to the left. Then press V to activate the selection tool and click off to deselect and take a look. So that's looking pretty cool. Using the same technique, I'm going to select some more of the petals, pressing and holding shift to select multiple shapes and add the pink color. So now it's just a simple case of taking the time to go around the rest of my artwork, selecting each piece individually, or selecting multiple shapes and adding color using the sample colors to the left. Soon, I will end up with something that looks like this. So that's looking pretty colorful. Now I am almost done here on the skull. The last thing I want to color in is the petal shapes around the eyes. Now what I want to do with these petals is apply a gradient that flows across them all. So let's take a look. So I'm going to zoom in on the eye here, and pressing and holding shift, I am carefully going to select each petal until I have them all selected. With them all selected, I'm going to press Command G to group these together. This means that I won't have to select them all individually again, as this can be quite time consuming. So then I'm going to press I and select the gradient effect I wish to apply to the petals. Now notice, when I choose the gradient, it applies the gradient effect to each petal. Well, I do not want this. I want to pass the gradient over all the petals as a whole. So next I will press G to activate the gradient tool. Then I'm going to click and drag from the top down like so, and notice how the gradient now flows over all the petals. Pretty cool. So using the same technique, I'm going to select all the petals on the left-hand side, group them by pressing Command G and apply the gradient effect, and use the gradient tool to reapply the gradient flow. Now you might not get the exact gradient flow on the neighboring example, so I'm going to use the selection tool to select both petal examples, and then again use the gradient tool on them both to get the same gradient effect on each of them like so. Easy. So that completes the colouring of the skull artwork, but now I want to add a background. So with the rectangle shape tool, I'm going to draw a rectangle on the canvas to the shape I desire like so, and I'm going to make it so we have a nice white margin around the outside. Then I'm going to press I to select a colour from my sample to the left. Now because this is the most recently created object on the same layer, it is set on top of my artwork. So I'm going to select my new shape, right click, scroll down to arrange and center back. Nice. So now my skull is looking pretty big on my canvas area. So now I'm going to make a selection over the skull like so. Notice how the background shape is also selected. Well, I'm going to press and hold shift, click the background area once to deselect that. So now I have just my skull artwork selected. I'm going to press Command G to group this. So now it's really easy to select this artwork as a whole in future. So with the whole artwork selected, I'm going to press S on the keyboard and holding shift, I'm going to click and drag inwards to scale the skull artwork down. And that's looking pretty cool. So now I want to create a white stroke around the outside of my skull. To do this, it's going to be really handy if I have a shape the same shape as my skull. Well, if we come back to the original drawing artwork, that's exactly what we have. So I'm going to select the outside stroke, copy, and paste it on top of my new artwork. And we can see it's currently a stroke. If I click the Swap Fill button on the Tools menu, we are now going to have a solid skull shape. So now I'm going to use the Scale tool to resize the vector to roughly the same size as my skull artwork. Now I'm going to change the color of both the fill and stroke to white in the tools menu. And then I'm going to start to push up the stroke size and then come to the stroke panel and set the stroke align to outline. So I'll push my stroke up to about 26. Then I'm going to press and hold shift on the keyboard and select the yellow background. With them both selected, I'm going to right click and scroll down to arrange and click center back. And now we have the background yellow and bold white stroke around our skull artwork. Excellent. Now I want to add some more visual elements to my poster design. I'm now going to add in a rose graphic. So I'm going to come up to File, scroll down to Place, and I'm going to navigate to an image in the project folder. I'm going to come to Test Project, Coloring, Coloring, Assets, and select the rose JPEG and click OK. Now the mouse cursor will change and ask where you want to place the image. Now be sure to click into your pasteboard area and not on top of your composition. So I'm going to click and now my image is placed into the pasteboard area away from my artwork. If you have downloaded the project folder, you will be able to do this too. So here we have the rose pixel image which I have found previously. Now I'm going to turn this into a vector, which I can work with. So with the image selected, I'm going to use the image trace tool. If you're using an older version of Illustrator, this will be the live trace tool. So I'm going to click the image trace tool and then click expand. Then I'm going to right click and select ungroup and click off to deselect. Then I'm going to click back onto the white part of the vector and press delete. So we have just converted the rose from a pixel image into a vector graphic, which I can start to work with. Excellent. Now notice, if I select parts of the rose, we can see it's all individual sections. So I'm going to make a selection over all the parts and press Command G to group these together. This is going to make it easier to work with. Now it's grouped, I'm going to introduce it into my composition. And using the rotation tools and the scale tool, I'm going to resize and position like so. So I'm going to press I on the keyboard to activate the eyedropper tool and then select a gradient effect I want from the left. And here we have the gradient applied to each section like so. Now remember on the eye section of the skull how we applied the gradient to the entire group? Well, on this occasion, I want to keep the gradient effect applied to each segment, though I want the gradient to be in the other direction. So currently, this little rose composition is grouped. If I click the rose with the selection tool, it will select the group. Though if I press A to activate the direct selection tool, we can click on each part of the group, like so. So with the individual part selected with the direct selection tool, I'm then going to press G on the keyboard to activate the gradient tool. I'm going to make sure that the fill color is selected in the tools menu and then click to change the flow of the gradient. And I want the gradient to be dark on the outside and fade into a lighter color on the inside. So with the direct selection tool, I'm going to select each individual part of the rose and alter the gradient flow until I have something like this. Now I want to put this rose behind the artwork to make it look like it's emerging from behind the thick white stroke around the skull artwork. So with the selection tool, I'm going to select the rose composition and the yellow background by holding shift on the keyboard, right click, scroll down to arrange and click center back. And there it is. So now I want the same rose on the other side, but pointing the other way. So I'll select the rose, press and hold Alt and drag across to duplicate like so. Then I'll come up to Object, Transform, hit Reflect, click OK, and there it is. So now it's a case of positioning the two roses until I'm happy with the overall composition. To make sure it's precise, I can select both the roses and come to the top in the control panel and click the Vertical Align Center button. And that will align them perfectly. So that completes the artwork coloring and composition for my poster design. Next, we are going to move into the t-shirt design over here on the right. So to begin, I'm literally going to select all the artwork I have just created by clicking and dragging over everything. Then I'm going to press and hold Alt and click and drag the entire composition over onto the next artboard. Upon release, we have a copy of the artwork. Okay, so the skull is still grouped, so I'm going to move this down a little, select the white shape behind, and press delete. I'm going to move the skull artwork back up, click the roses, and drag them out. So now I'm going to apply some new colors to this artwork. This t-shirt design is going to be printed using Pantone colors, as requested by the printer. As you can see here to the right, I have a selection of Pantone colors with their reference numbers. Now, if you too have Pantone references from Pantone books you wish to include in your artwork, this is how to incorporate them. So I'm going to come over to the swatches panel and click on the top right menu button. From the drop-down, I'm going to come to the bottom and move my mouse over Open Swatch Library. Then you will see another menu appear. Then I'm going to roll my mouse over Color Books, and then another list will appear. And here we have the library of many color books, including a series of Pantone books. Now, I am looking for solid coated Pantone colors. So I'll click the solid coated book, and up will pop a new tab full of Pantone solid coated colors. Great. So now I'm going to search for my Pantone colors by typing in the number in the search box above. So I'm going to start with my t-shirt color. So that's 219, and there it is. Now, I want to keep hold of this Pantone as I'll be using it a lot. So I'll click and drag this swatch into my swatches panel like so. Nice. So I'll search for my next color, 7744, and drag it into my swatches panel. Using this technique, I'll soon have all four colors in my swatches panel ready to use. Excellent. So now I have my Pantone colors in my swatches panel, I'm ready to apply these colors to the artwork. So I'm going to select the background yellow, then come across and select the magenta Pantone color. Then I'm going to select my skull artwork, which is currently grouped. Now notice down in the tools menu, we have a question mark over the fill. This is because we have multiple vectors selected with multiple colors. With it all selected, I'm going to come over to the swatches panel and select the greenish yellow Pantone color. And the whole artwork will change. Then I'm going to right click and ungroup the artwork. With the selection tool, I'm carefully going to select the outline part of the artwork, then come into the swatches panel and select the dark gray color. And just like that, we have removed all the colors from the previous example, and we have the skull artwork in two Pantone colors. Then I'm going to click the two roses, come to the swatches panel, and select the greenish yellow Pantone. So now I'm going to proceed to color in the various details in the skull artwork. I'm going to select the parts of my vector artwork I want to change, and then use the Pantone swatches in the swatches panel. And soon I will have something that looks like this. Now I must mention at this point that currently we have the background and various elements of the artwork filled with the t-shirt color Pantone. At the moment, this is just for design and layout purposes. Remember, this will be printed onto a t-shirt, and it will be the t-shirt that creates this magenta part of the color in the artwork. So this will be removed later on. We will be covering this in the exporting artwork video in future. Now this time, I'm going to do something different with my roses. So I'm going to press A on the keyboard and click a part of the rose. By holding Shift, I can select more parts of the rose. With my selection, I'm going to come over to the swatches panel and select the yellow Pantone like so. Then I'm going to click off to deselect and press V to activate the selection tool and reselect the rose to select it as a group. Then I'm going to come to the tools menu and select the stroke color. Then come over to the swatches panel and apply the black Pantone. I'm going to push up the stroke weight and change the stroke align to outside. I'll push up the weight to around 6 points, and that's looking pretty cool. I'm going to reposition and rotate until I'm happy. I'm going to select the other rose and delete it, and then copy and paste my new rose, reflect the artwork, and reposition like so. Then I'll select both roses and come up to the control panel and click the vertical align center button. This will align them perfectly like so. And that completes the coloring of the t-shirt design. So now I have my poster design to the left with CMYK color swatches and gradient effects, and my t-shirt design to the right in strictly Pantone colors. So to finish off, I'm going to save the document. I'm going to come to File Save and save my document to the desktop and save it as Skull Color. Make sure you save your document somewhere safe, as we will be using this document in the next video. So that covers coloring vectors and using Pantone color books to source Pantone references to incorporate them into our artwork. In the next video, we will be finalizing our poster and t-shirt designs by adding type. See you in the next video.